Yo, yo, yo. CPA Strength here, back again with another video. Not just any video, a long layoff from Accounting for Beginners. I'm going back. This is Accounting for Beginners number 94. I have 93 other videos in this playlist, hence the 94th. This is my classic series. This is my classic series. Go over here. You can go hit the card, and then I'll bring you to the playlist, best accounting playlist in the world. I'm gonna try to keep this one short and simple. This is the first accounting video in my new place, so let's just get into it. I wanna help people out, and hopefully this will help people out. I know it'll help someone out. Let's go to my, I have a question. I'm gonna answer a question, so leave a question, leave a comment. Leave a like. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. It helps the channel out. The comments, likes helps the channel out. Yeah, I gotta grind. So, oh, I just wanted to say before I started this question, thank you for 65,000 subscribers. We just hit 65,000 subscribers. Crazy. I don't want to talk too much in this video. I want it to be informational and answer a question and have other vlogs and videos and everything. But anyways, thank you for rocking with me. Thanks for supporting with me. Let's go, road to 100K. Let's go, road to 100K. Let's answer this accounting question. Hi, I have a question. Why are some entries on the right credit side considered assets? Now, when I was reading that, I like that. He said, the right, left, right, Why are some entries on the right credit side? So the right side is the credit side, yes. And that's how, see, he already knows that, that's already good. He says, well, I thought assets were only on the debit side. He thought the assets were only on the debit side. The debit side, meaning the left. So anyways, that's the question. He says, why are assets on both the left debit side or right credit side? And credit's the right side. Of what though? Oh, I guess this middle line. I need to come up with a name. I need to come up with a name for this line. But it's the middle line right here. The debit is left and the credit is right. Now let's go over to my formula DCAdler over here. I didn't write it all out. If you want to know about it, if it's your first video, please watch the playlist, watch some other videos. Debit, credit. This is asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue, DCAdler. We're going to talk about the A, which is for assets. The A is for assets here in DCAdler. Now I know where this person's coming from, because I always say DCAdler. I always give you this formula, like it's the formula to remember. That's all you're gonna need to know. And I understand. A for assets are over here under the debit side. So why is sometimes an asset on the credit side? Because I have it in DCAdler labeled over here. Now for debit and credit, they don't switch back, okay? Asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue can either increase or decrease. All six of these boxes can either be increased or decreased. Let's just concentrate on the assets right now. All right, an asset is debit, left side, if increasing. See, DCAdler is always here in the positive form. Everything, all of DCAdler is assumed that it's in increasing level. So assets increase, debit. Expenses increase, debit. Assets decrease, credit. Expenses decrease, credit. Anyways, assets. If an asset is credit on the right side, if decreasing. So That's what all these line up in the increasing side. And if they're decreasing, you reverse the aid blur. Well, let's just specifically, what we're doing with the assets, if something's where it's labeled in the positive side or the increasing side, all of the other boxes here can be done the same way. Let's just focus on assets. And his question was, why are some assets on the credit side? When you have assets on the debit side lined up over there on the debit side, why are some of the assets on the credit side? Because they're in positive form here. So if an asset is increasing, we debit it. So that would be, we'll just say, okay, cash, or let's just say checking account. Cash, checking account, all right, is increasing $500. Increasing 500 cash. What else is maybe increasing 10,000. I don't want to be increasing 10,000 truck. That's a fixed asset, a truck. Cash is a current asset. What's another asset? Plus 20,000 in loan to somebody. You loan the money to somebody. Loan to. Because a loan to money is an asset. Loan to shareholder, we'll just say. Loan to shareholder. These are all assets increasing, that's why they're on debit side. Okay? Should've done the green. But let's say here
we got the credit side. Why would an asset be on the credit side, the right side, if it was decreasing?
So instead of, so cash, we had cash, we had 500 cash increasing over here, and it was a debit side, a debit. So we're gonna have negative 500 cash, and that's gonna be a credit. Because we're decreasing the asset, so it's a credit. Now for a truck, we sell the truck. We don't have the truck anymore. So now we're gonna have a negative 10,000 truck. All right, so we have less of an asset. An asset is decreasing. And the third one is, the shareholder paid back the $20,000, so the loan to shareholder account is reducing, because it was $20,000. Now they paid us $20,000, so this account is reducing, so it's going to be a credit. Loan to shareholder. This one's a little bit trickier. Okay, so this is an asset. $20,000 loan to shareholder. That's decreasing the loan to shareholder account. So if it's an asset account. All right, it's a non-current asset. So if you're increasing an asset account, which a loan to shareholder is an asset for the company, because You've owned it to them, and they owe it back to you, so it's money coming your way, so that's an asset. And if it's increasing, we're debiting it.
If it's if this account's decreasing, if someone paid you back, the person paid you back the $20,000, that would be a decrease in the loan to shareholder account. If it's decreasing in an asset account, it's gonna be credit. Let's just go over the truck real fast. Truck, fixed asset. You buy a truck, the truck account between a fixed asset account would be debited because it's increasing, because you're increasing the account by $10,000 because now you have a new fixed asset worth $10,000. You sell the truck, you get rid of the truck and it's valued at $10,000, or you get rid of the truck, and you get $10,000 for that fixed asset truck. So now, in that same account, the truck account, it's gonna be decreasing because you're no longer gonna have that fixed account anymore. So it's gonna be decreasing, you know, by $10,000. So that would be a credit because you have an asset account decreasing. And same with the cash. Cash is a current asset. If it's increasing, if you just got some more cash, I like to work with cash a lot because it's easier to, I guess, instinctually see. So, anyways, cash is an asset. If cash is increasing, that's a debit. If cash is decreasing, that's a credit. So you can just go through, you gotta figure out a bunch of different things, but one of them is, do you need is it an asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue? What kind of account is it? And is it increasing or decreasing? Find those things out, then you'll know if it's on the left or right side, or if it is debit or a credit. Anyways, this video went long enough. This was really fun to be back. Catch my groove a little bit. Anyways, thanks for watching. I love doing these. I love I let y'all go, but at least for about the next 4 months, I'm gonna be going super hard, hopefully a lot longer than that. Anyways, this is CPA Strength, and I'm out. Deuces.